My name is Kacper. I'm a senior research engineer. I work for Quantstamp. We are building a protocol for auditing smart contracts. Basically, our mission is to make smart contracts secure, because that's one of the main issues right now. We do a few things. So the most important one is building the network, where basically you can submit a smart contract, and then we do an automated analysis, and you get a report. Then based on that report, you can get information about potential security issues, and it gives you an opportunity to fix the smart contract. For EDCON, I was really excited about the session that was about formal verification, or, you know, or computer-aided verification of smart contracts. Because overall, I think it is a good community here. There are a lot of developers, but there are also some people who are into research. I think it is a really great opportunity to share some of the knowledge with developers and present that knowledge in a way that they can easily understand, and maybe they can even start adopting. I think that this Plasma may be one of the more promising solutions for scalability. And, you know, there are different trade-offs there, because it does introduce a certain level of centralization, but then it allows you to scale throughput much better. Of course, there are some new issues, as we know. So for example, like mass exits in case of issues with the Plasma chain are an interesting topic. So yeah, I'm really looking forward to seeing the progress, especially in Plasma. So I think that formal verification, or let's say computer-aided verification, is a great use case in Ethereum and in smart contracts, because we know that overall these methods are expensive and they require a lot of expertise to apply. However, we as Quantstamp and some other projects, we try to make them more accessible. Now, why would developers care about it? Well, because their contracts handle or will handle large amounts of money. So, you know, it is really worth putting the effort and making sure that the code is correct. I think it is unlikely that an average developer will be using formal verification in the sense of constructing mathematical proofs on their own. I think that instead they will be using push button verification tools that provide, you know, a little bit less assurance, though in practice it should be enough assurance to classify contract as secure with respect to some properties that they like to validate.